Seven regional champions will converge on Purdue University April 5th for the 21st annual Rube Goldberg Machine Contest. Those teams of university engineering students from around the nation are feverishly tinkering with machines designed to perform a common task, assemble a hamburger in as many nonsensical, whimsical, entertaining, counterintuitive steps as possible. The Purdue Society of Professional Engineers will vie for its third national championship in 4 years. Captain Drew Wisher says the team invested more than 4,000 man-hours to prepare for the regional competition alone.
We start in early September, and we just work nonstop all the way till the end. Last night, we didn't have any sleep. We were working all the way up until we got here, which was 2 hours before competition. We love it. It's for me, at least, it's a wonderful way to just get out of schoolwork and just tinker. I love working with my hands, and yeah, I'm a pilot in my career, but I also, you know, love to just build things, you know, take different things, put them together, make them work.
The national field will be rounded out by Penn State, the University of Arizona, Texas A&M, the Michigan Technological Institute, Ferris State, and the University of Texas. Chinadu Indom, a member of Purdue's National Society of Black Engineers team, says even though he won't be competing for the national championship, the exerted effort for the regional was worthwhile.
It's a fun event. You get to work with people. Lots of engineering experience, using creativity, putting ideas, taking them from just a thought, really nothing tangible, and making it into something tangible. And it's also, you know, kind of a sense of ownership, almost like a baby, as you refer to it as, you know, you start working on it, give it ideas, devote time, and it's like, you know, I want to see it, you know, grow up, basically.
Purdue Society of Professional Engineers will face a stiff challenge from several teams, including the returning 2007 national champs, Ferris State, a team that upset Purdue last year with a toy factory-themed machine that proved impeccable at pouring orange juice. The machines are graded in large part on how many steps they include and how reliable the machine is. Purdue's team is still working on both components.
We had too many interventions, one on the first run and one on the third run. We've got to, you know, get that completely taken care of, just wipe it out. And I'm sure we'll be adding a few steps here and there just to, you know, integrate some things that we wanted to do but we couldn't do for this competition.
Judge Matt Kosis, an engineer with event sponsor Rockwell Collins, says this year's assigned task is harder than past years. He said the victorious Purdue machine is well conceived and constructed, but he also looks for the creative thinking cartoonist Rube Goldberg was known for.
Gives you teamwork experience. That's going to be important immediately. You're going to have to work on a team anywhere you go. But I like it because it gives you a creative way to explore something, add something new, and troubleshooting. You're going to do this in real life. You're going to build something that's not going to work. How can you improve it?
Kosis says his company's investment in the event is an investment in the future of engineering. He says some of the best engineering recruits in the nation come from universities such as Purdue that encourage their students to put their education to tangible, if not always efficient, use. At Purdue University, I'm Jim Shank.